something being necessary versus being just desirable and material that's there because it needs to be, or it's there because in that moment or in that touch, in that moment of improvising, it had to be that thing to exist with the other, like that after note, I love that quote, to make this thing then click and become what you see on the wall. And that's just something that I'm not even sure I'm like getting there, but that's just a question recently of, you know, is this paint stroke really necessary? And not overthinking it either. I'm not like sitting there going, are you necessary? It's more of, it's in the thing, and you can maybe take a moment to breathe with it, and you're going, is this going down a path of these things have to be doing this, or is it going, I'm just sort of fluffing around, and I'm just messing with, just, I don't know, I'm just phoning it in for the day in the studio. That's the thing that really strikes me in both of your work, the act of necessity in both of them, whether it be the removing and the whole, like the slow burn of the process to get to this. I mean, I talked to you about the slippage in that top right corner, like that little sliver of escape route of material and just sort of thin to, I don't know, that red layer on top. And then with the drawings, and I think of soutine for your portraits as well. The soutine in the Barnes Foundation on the second floor, it looks like he's painting that in his last breath or something. It's insane. It's really just magic. It's really quite remarkable to me. And that's what these do. It's sort of this magical alchemy of material. And even though you're saying the importance of the hand is there, there's also just as many moments where the hand is just invisible and it just becomes the role of the paint and the colored mud. And it just forms, and you go, how the hell is that happening? And that's like the coolest thing to look at.
That's sort of the paradox. When you said that at the opening, that sort of had me rethink my whole thing. But I can't, you know, it's sort of like things like that, they exist in a deep way because they're a paradox. You know, like the hand is there, but it's sort of, how did that happen?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then the other thing is like the characteristic of, so I love paintings personally, and I like to make paintings that do this, where, you know, the sort of falling away, the dissolving, and the happening, like it's being formed at the same time. That's where these paintings exist, but almost the needle clicks more towards they could fall apart at any moment, and then the role of the viewer to walk up and keep the thing together is something that I like to, it makes it fun for me as the maker, because I look at it as a viewer and I'm like, holy crap. Get the scaffolding. But then John and Shannon, there's moments where you're responsible for holding it together, but more so it's more of like a sifting through. Like it's more of a, if a painting that I'm making is a, oh boy, let's fortify it and hold it up, it's more about kind of like pulling the curtain, or there's layers that you can dive into and move deeper into the pieces, which again, I don't know, just sort of these common threads. So anyway, that's what I was thinking about today before we're speaking.
Cool. Excellent.
Yeah. It's funny, you were talking about, you know, this painting over here. What I really like about your work is like, one of my favorites is the big arrow on that second, but this one, we were talking, you know, I assume that's the toilet on top, the top part of the toilet.
So this, these are my shorts.
Oh, okay. Even better.
With the belt buckle, and this is this weird grape thing that's right there.
Okay, okay, okay.
And
nice.
It's kind of this magnificent thing.
You gotta go,
yeah. I don't know why you have to share.
But you talk about, like, you know, I'm taking moments of almost like a still life. But then it's not at all. Like, there's that push and pull between, like, catching glimpses of, all right, now that I'm looking at it a little deeper, then I can understand that there really is a lot of distraction in the observation. Mm-hmm. And it's funny, because my son's 4 years old, he came in and he was like, wow. He saw these and he was like, look at those, why do we have those? Why do we have these kind of outlets? And it was true, like for a second I was like, wow, they're really creative here. They figured out how to even make outlets. That's interesting. And that kind of stuck with me, that my son's 4 and he sees this observation or something, and he's like, gathered like an experience from a 2.
Yeah.
Which is, you know, it's very interesting that you can touch somebody at that age, and then also, you know, the more trained eye, not that, you know, we all went through the experience of being, you know, in art school, and but so obviously he hasn't yet. Maybe he will be. I don't know. Hmm. But you know, he found something right away with that that was interesting to him. And I think, you know, I absolutely love the one over here. I pointed that out to my husband earlier today. Because again, like, it's not, you talked about your subject matter being things that are around you, whether or not that was important, or I don't know how you were putting it, but I was like, that's actually not the case at all. Because like with John, it's a means to an end. It's like the desperation of like, I want to paint something. I don't know what I'm going to paint, but I see this area that's in my life and I want to record it, and I'm going to do it. Not just record it, but I'm going to believe, put emotion into it too, which is really, you know, both you and John, you know, it goes past observational painting. I think observational painting is very important, you know, as a basis for everything that you do, but you're working observationally, but it's transcends being just an observational thing. It's like finding the necessity of doing, I need something, you know, so this is such a, like, a, almost like a desperation to be able to get out what it is that, you know, as an artist that you want to do, that I find both of you have such a great ability to do.
That's awesome.
I like to, I mean, I don't know, I think a lot about, like, I mean, or just, I don't know, these are thoughts I'm having, I guess, just the, I like the skin, I guess, that idea of the skin, and I feel like that's one thing that I really enjoy about your work is, it's almost like there's multiple paintings. You know, I guess I like the importance, I guess, of each mark, and I'm not very, very articulate here, I guess, but like I feel like there's small paintings within each painting. Like I look at this and I see like, wow, you know, this accumulation of these marks, and each mark seems so complete, I guess, on its own and enjoyable, and has, again, this sense of speed and a personality of thickness and whatnot. And, you know, and then you sort of zoom out, and it does also then, you know, this little collection of marks kind of moving, again, across the sort of skating across the skin and interacting that way. In some ways I feel like that relates somewhat to what Shannon's saying, I guess, in terms of it is about the things that are here, but it's also simply, you know, about the abstraction, you know, of how all of these individual marks are fitting together, I guess. Beyond that, I feel like, again, it does make us start to think about, you know, it has such specificity of light, right? You know, like, this is a certain time of day, this is a certain place. It makes me think more about, like, whose environment is this? And I like all those questions that I start to ask, like, who lives here? Like, what are they doing? You know, where is this space? What's going on? You know, is it a quiet environment? You know, I feel like I start to think about all these things that are actually not in the painting, too, at the same time, that's triggered by how things are put, you know, the objects that are here and how they're put together and whatnot, too. And then also the energy of the paint. I know that I've seen, you know, that I definitely think about her with this group of work, but then also seeing some of your, you know, a lot of your other work, painters like Lois Dodd in particular,
yeah,
like really come to mind. And
my hero, yeah.
and you know, I think there's a certain similarity, like those paintings are from like this environment that is deeply personal to her, but it's not just, here are these things, you know, it's, and I want you to enjoy the plasticness of those things. It really becomes about like what life is going on, like in and around those things, right? And in that space, for, you know, for me, like that's how I guess these paintings feel. Like, I, you know, that painting that Shannon was talking about in particular is another one that I really like as well. And, you know, feel like the color choices and the chroma choices and everything also give me this feeling about like, oh God, not at 5:20.
Yeah.
Do I have to you know, I guess I feel like those kinds of marks, the way they're applied, the speed at which they're applied, and again, all that, all those other formal choices, you know, really feel appropriate for the feelings that, you know, are take place in that particular space, you know, at that particular time, you know, by this particular person. And I think that's, again, like, those are the things that to me make them really effective, is because I can then, you know, that I get that in that painting, and then that makes me feel, you know, more connected to it because of my own experience in my own specific environment, I guess. So.
Sean, did you have a project where you were documenting your house or family house? I mean, you were through it and you were like painting it before the house.
Yes. And that is still happening.
Actually, yes. So in that case, like, the thing is important, and then there seems to be a connection between the rapidity of the execution, but there's a desperate need to get it all done.
Yeah.
I mean, you're like creating a house painting by painting, and the color like seems to be enhanced. Like sometime like an old incandescent bulb would fire, burn brighter before it goes out. So there's this, like a similar like intensity when I saw some of those paintings. So I didn't know like what connection, if there's that similar thinking here, or is that project still going on?
Well, yeah, the project is definitely still going on. And it's funny because that project was actually, I thought it was coming up a different kind of deadline. So those paintings were triggered by a deadline that I thought was going to happen for having the time to work with the house, but in fact, it, the deadline was extended. However, the deadline is also very soon approaching again. So there's a new deadline, and I really like the idea that kind of like this theme of disparity, like this desperation, sort of like really giving the most it can possibly give in a moment, really feeds, I think, into the color choices. Actually, that makes a lot of sense. This sort of like oversaturation, like, ooh, real quick, last exhale before the end. In terms of these, this had me thinking differently because, it's still existing within the house, but it made me question, and I think you answered what I was trying to say earlier in a much better sentence, but the life around the stuff, and it made me think of it in like on an individual basis as me this time, like the slivers of me going through a day versus the slivers of the whole building and structure of the house, which I think I did end up addressing things a little differently from those other paintings. So the house paintings were more of a, like, in memoriam to a moment from this structure, trying to encapsulate like just the memories and history of whoever lived there and existed in the room, where this is just sort of, you know, it's almost like making monuments of totally non-monumental things at all, just like and yet still having meaning. Like the green in this door was, my sister lived on the third floor of this house, and she used the green light bulb for the veterans because she's married to a Marine. So that's another little slippage for me to know, but it kind of comes across for everybody else as like, what the hell is going on with that? So yeah, I don't know if I answered it, but I feel like that there's a bit of a different tone with these, similar fashion, but just a little something different going on, because it's more of a me, like a one-to-one me to the painting versus a like a one to whatever the scale shift would be for the house documentation.
And also maybe the momentary versus cumulative.
Yes.
Right, I guess.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, like,
yeah.
What,
I think going back to the life around the things, that's what working with this exhibition and seeing your works sort of has made me learn and rethink about in my studio practice is, you know, like, okay, before I was sort of making, this is closer to sort of how I used to look at it. I'm not dissing them, but the idea of sort of getting us to pay attention to a moment and just that moment, where this sort of helped me open a little bit more back up and go, well, what could potentially be happening with that thing or with that moment and the person living with that moment? And like, you know, that might be the closest to figuration I'll ever get because I'm terrified of using people in paintings. I just talk about not wanting to talk to them in your studio as a model. Screw it, I just go to an outlet. Your jump is making your own model. I'm like, all right, I'm gonna go to the wall or the molding on the floor. So